हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। हियर आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ बाइनरी ट्री अ नॉन लीनियर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। फ्रॉम दिस बाइनरी ट्री आई एम गोइंग टू कवर द कंसेप्ट ऑफ थ्रेडेड बाइनरी ट्री इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज। सो आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the threaded binary tree concept. For the introduction of threaded binary tree, you can go to my previous video, which is introduction to threaded binary tree. For your reference, I am providing you a shortcut link in this right up corner. And the next part of this video series is to learn types of threaded binary tree. At a glance, let's see what is threaded binary tree. So whenever you are going to represent a binary tree, then there are some null pointers are available into the link part of the node. The null pointers can be off if the node is having only one child node and if both child are absent, that is no children node. That is a leaf node. In both the cases, there will be the null pointer, and we will make the use of that null pointer for the construction of threaded binary tree. So here you can see the example. These are the null pointers for the node B, and for node C these are the null pointers, because here B and C both are the leaf nodes. So we will make the use of these null pointers to construct it as a threaded binary tree. Before that, or before going to construction or the operations that can be performed on a binary threaded binary tree, let's see what are the types of threaded binary tree. So mainly the threaded binary tree is having two types. The first one is single threaded binary tree, and the second type is fully threaded binary tree, or it may have both the threads available. So let's start with the first type, is nothing but the single threaded binary tree. Again, it is divided into two parts. The first one is left threaded binary tree, and the second one is right threaded binary tree. The name itself suggests that single thread means either only the left thread is present or only the right thread is present. So these are two different types of single threaded binary tree, depending upon the thread which is present in a left pointer or in a right pointer. So let's see more details about threaded binary tree. What is single threaded binary tree? So let's see, if it is a left threaded binary tree, then what does it mean? It means that if some of the node has no left child, then the left pointer will point to its in order predecessor, because thread will hold the address of its predecessor, in order predecessor. If it is left, it will hold the address of in order predecessor. Means if the left pointer is null, instead of that null pointer, we will save the address of, we will store the address of in order predecessor at the position of null. The second type is right threaded binary tree. Just opposite to the left threaded binary tree, right threaded binary tree, if the no right child is present, means at right pointer the null value is there, and that null value we are going to replace with in order successor. See, these things you have to keep in mind, that if a left pointer is null, it will be holding the predecessor, in order predecessor's address, and if a right pointer is null, it will be holding the in order successor's address. And if both the cases, that is if the successor or the predecessor is not present for any of the nodes, see, for example, if the leftmost child is there for your binary tree and its left child is not present, leftmost child node's left pointer is null. In this case, no predecessor will be available, and the same case with the rightmost child of your binary tree and its right pointer is null. There, in that case, then the successor, in order successor, will not be present. if this is the situation, then in both the situation, what we have to do? We will point both, that is the left pointer and the right pointer, to the header node. Here I am going to explain you all these things with the help of example. So let's see the example of left threaded binary tree. Here you can see that this is a binary tree and the node 12, its left pointer is null as no left child is present. And this is the leftmost child of your tree, so that's why in order predecessor is also not present. So what it will do? It will point to the header node and header will hold the address of its root node. The next node is 30, its left pointer is also null. Instead of null value, what we will do? We will store the address of in order predecessor, which is nothing but 23. See students, for the learning of threaded binary tree, you must know the concept of first of all binary tree, as well as you must be very much clear about the traversal of the binary tree, specifically the in order traversal. If you are not knowing these two concepts, then this will be difficult to understand the threaded binary tree. So that's why I'll recommend you to go through the binary tree first of all, then its traversal, and then you can go forward for the threaded binary tree if you are not knowing the concept of binary tree and its traversal. Here I am hoping that you are knowing the concept of binary tree as well as its traversal, and hence I am moving forward for the next point or the next example of single threaded binary tree is right threaded binary tree. Just opposite to this, here we are taking care of only the right pointer if it is null. So in this single threaded binary tree, you can see that we are taking care of only the left pointer if it is null. We will point it to the in order predecessor, and in a right threaded binary tree, we will take care of only the right pointer if it is null. It will point to the in order successor. Here you can see that this is the rightmost item or rightmost node of your binary tree. As it is a rightmost node, there will not be any in order successor. So that's why it is pointing to the header node, and header node is pointing to the root node. So in this way, the single threaded binary will look like. And now let's go forward for the second main type of threaded binary tree. It's a fully threaded binary tree. Just now we have seen the single threaded binary tree, where we had taken care of only the left pointer in left threaded binary tree and the right pointer in a right threaded binary tree. But here in fully threaded binary tree, we will take care of both the pointers. So for a node which is having a null field in a left pointer, then the left pointer will point to its in order predecessor. In the same way, if a node is having null field in a right pointer, then the right pointer will point to its in order successor. So both the things we are going to take care of in the fully threaded binary tree. And as we are taking care of left pointer as well as a right pointer, if they are null, that's why the name is given fully threaded binary tree. And as I explained previously, if no successor or the predecessor is present, then it will point to the header node that we have already seen in the previous example. So now let's see the example of fully threaded binary tree. So what it says, the fully threaded binary tree will take care of both the pointers, that is a left pointer if it is null, it will point to its in order predecessor. Here you can see that for the node 30, the in order predecessor is 23. So blue pointers are helping you to identify the left pointer, they are null and they are pointing to in order predecessor. And the red pointers are red, or the red threads will help you to identify the in order successor as its right pointer is null. And in case of node 12, its left, as it is the leftmost node of the binary tree, hence its in order predecessor is not present, hence it is pointing to the header node. And same case with node 89, as it is the rightmost node of your binary tree, hence the in order successor is not present, and that's why it is pointing to the header node. So this is the example of fully threaded binary tree. And now if we want to construct this fully threaded binary tree, we must have to understand the node structure of threaded binary tree. Not only the fully, but if we want to implement the single thread binary tree, that is left thread or a right thread binary tree, and if a fully threaded binary tree, then what the node structure will be there. So that's why let's see the node structure of a threaded binary tree. For a binary tree, all of us are knowing the node structure, where mainly the things are present are nothing but the data field, its left pointer and its right pointer. The extra thing is added is nothing but a flag variable, is of type boolean. Here, as it is a left thread binary tree, it will be having the left flag variable, and in case of right threaded binary tree, along with the left data and a right pointer, these three fields are common as far as the binary tree is concerned, but the R flag is one extra field is added of type boolean. Here I am explaining you the importance of this L flag variable in case of left threaded binary tree and R flag variable in case of right threaded binary tree. What we have decided, that if the left pointer is holding the null value, what we will do, we will copy the address of in order predecessor in this left pointer. So to identify whether this left pointer is holding the address of its left child or the in order predecessor, the L flag variable will help us. If this L flag variable, it is a boolean variable, if this L flag variable is 1, that is true, it indicates that the left pointer will hold the thread which will hold the address of in order predecessor. And in the same case with the R flag variable, that is, if it is true, it is 1, it indicates that this right pointer is holding the thread, it means that it is holding the address of in order successor, as this is the right pointer. And in both the cases, if L flag and R flag are 0, it means that they are false value, it indicates that the left pointer is holding the address of left child and R pointer, right pointer, is holding the address of right child. Means the threads are not present, the child nodes are present. So in this way we can denote the node structure of single threaded binary tree. And now let's see the node structure of fully threaded binary tree. Along with this left pointer data field and a right pointer, two flag variables are there, L thread and R thread. As we have seen previously, L thread will hold the boolean value either true or false. In the same case, R thread will also hold the boolean value, that is true or false. Let's see the representation in your programming language. So I am going to use the structure for the representation of this node. These things all of you are knowing, that is a left pointer will hold the address of left child or the left thread. This right pointer will hold the address of right child or the right thread. This data field will hold the information part of your node structure. And the main part is L thread and R thread, as they are of type boolean. See, I have mentioned the condition over here. If this boolean value is true, then the left pointer points to in order predecessor. Means if it is true, it will hold the thread. And the same case, if a right pointer, it will hold the address of in order successor. It is nothing but a thread again. And in opposite case, if it is false, it will hold the address of this boolean. If both the values are false, this left pointer and right pointer will hold the address of left child and right child respectively. So other way around, just keep in mind that These boolean value will help you to identify what is there in this left pointer as well as in right pointer. If thread is true, the left thread or R thread, right thread, these boolean variables are true, it will be holding the thread values to in order predecessor and in order successors respectively. And if this L thread and R thread values are false, it indicates that the left pointer and the right pointer are holding the address of left child and right child respectively. So in this way we can represent a node structure in our threaded binary tree. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, please like the video, subscribe my channel Tech Talks and share it with your friends. For your reference, I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel Tech Talks along with the video of this video series. Thank you. Happy learning. Happy data structuring. Thank you.